Right, so this is going to be an overview video of one of my personal guns. This is my outdoor pistol. So I use this pistol for outdoors if I want to play with just the pistol. So I run this guy shooting at right at 400 feet per second because I don't want to have the DMR rules that we have around here. So 400 is the max FPS you can have on a gun without it being considered a DMR, right? So this is a Terran tacticalized pistol. It is all custom, so this is not like the Baba Yaga or the EMG TTI guns. This is a full custom build, right? So we're gonna start off with some of the externals before we get to the internals. The first thing you might notice is my barrel. My barrel is it is a steel cow tornado style barrel, and it's threaded, and I have added basically a barrel extension onto the end of my gun so I can extend my inner barrel out to about there. That's going to help me get right up to that limit without going on insane air pressures. One of the other things about this gun is going to be I have all steel parts for my slide catch, my thumb rest, my safety. That's all steel on this gun, which is going to be nice, very durable. Don't have to worry about those. My lower is going to be an Airsoft Masterpiece advanced frame. So this is the STI International, so it's the one that matches the gun. So if this was a real gun, these two would mate together. They'd be correct. They wouldn't be breaking the lore of the gun world or anything like that. I try to go with silver accents a little bit on my gun. So I got my silver on the tornado barrel poking through over there. I got my silver trigger, and I have a silver hammer back here. That is going to be a two-tone hammer, so I got black on the top, just that way it's not going to be super flashy there. So tornado barrel again. So I have the fluting on it. It looks super wicked. I really like it. I've had this barrel for a very, very, very long time. I've had this barrel for probably about 5 years or so, and I've had this gun for like 3 years or so. And I do have a stippled grip. So this is a hand stippled grip. It isn't one of those molded ones. So this is all done by hand. Very, very, very grippy. It's probably one of the grippiest stipple styles that I've ever handled personally, at least. I have the magwell. It matches the rest of the gun there. You got your Terran Tactical Magwell. Everything's all very similar color, except for I do have shiny black accents on the slide up here. So I have the matte black along with the shiny black for some of the accents. I think it looks fine. It doesn't look bad or anything like that. I do have fiber optic sights. I have, this is a cow front sight with a fiber optic in there. And then I have an STI style rear iron sight with blue fiber optics. I don't really recommend the blue fiber optics. They're not super bright. I just have them on there because I think it looks cool. That's the main reason I do most of my stuff, is I like stuff to look cool, right? So that's about everything on the outside. I do have a little bit of an extended magazine release, so it pokes up just a little bit. Not too much. It doesn't poke up as much as the Evike version of the gun does. But it is extended. I think it's a nice length of extension. It's not a terrible length of extension. All right, so now I'm going to take this guy apart. I'll show you the internals on the upper. So we're just going to get that guy back there. And the only thing I don't like about this gun is my pin is very, very hard to press out. So I always have to grab a punch to press it out, which is very, very hard to get out. And that is the pin's fault. That is not the fault of the slide or the frame. That is just the pin and the way that the pin is designed. It's a specific style of pin. It's not like your classic style of pin. Right, so we have that off, so I'm going to pull this gun off, and I will let you know, I do not clean this gun. This gun has only been cleaned once, And that time, after I cleaned it, the gun shot terribly. So I have decided that this gun's just never going to be cleaned. It shoots super nice. It shoots very reliably when it's clean because I do run this at higher pressures. So it's not going to be a big deal with the griminess causing the gun to jam up. So down here, I have kind of golden internals. I wanted the internals to kind of stand out and match and be different than the externals of the gun. So I got Airsoft Masterpiece housing, and then Airsoft Masterpiece hop-up unit. The Airsoft Masterpiece hop-up unit is probably the best hop-up unit you can get for hi-capa. It's probably one of the top upgrades that I recommend for any players to get. It's just super duper nice. In here, this nozzle is a, I don't know what it's called, but it's from Airsoft Gateway. It's their like juggernaut nozzle. It's very, very, very durable. It's apparently super hard to break. I obviously have not broken mine yet. And I don't know anybody who has. Who knows if it will break. We'll see as the future goes on. But as far as I'm aware, these are one of the most durable nozzles you can get for this gun here. I do have the cow guide rod set up here. So it's a couple pieces in here. It's fine. If I were to build this gun again, I probably wouldn't use this. I'd probably use the standard style. But this, it works for me, so I just keep it in there. That's pretty much it. I have maple leaf bucking in there, along with a tight bore barrel that's gonna be extended. It goes out extra far there. And we'll go back here. And there's not much that I can really show you. I have all the internals all upgraded in there. You kind of have to, if you're doing the advanced frame, you basically need to upgrade those. Yeah, that's about it there. Not much else to show you without taking stuff apart. And I'm not going to take this apart because that's a pain, and I don't clean this gun anyways. So I'm not gonna get into that there. All right. So this is my outdoor hi-capa pistol. If you want to see some of my other videos, I have a playlist on my channel for my personal guns. I already have one gun uploaded before this, and that is my AAP-01. I have that video uploaded. The video code for that one is T-001, don't listen to what I just said. The video code on this, on the AAP-01 is M-001, all right? I'm new to this YouTube thing, and I'm trying to get a system in place, and sometimes I get my words caught up there, but M001 is the video code for my video on my my previous video on my personal AAP-01. All right, so that's about it there. I hope you enjoyed a little video of one of my personal guns. I will see you here in the near future. All right, have a nice day.